If you haven't already noticed, we're going to be doing things a little bit differently today. The Sedin twins have retired, which I still hasn't really fully sunken in yet. The Sedin twins have been on the Canucks for as long as I've been a fan of the Vancouver Canucks. I identify the Vancouver Canucks with the Sedin twins, and it's going to be super, super weird not seeing number 22 and number 33 on the ice. And so I've been thinking these past couple 24, the past 24 hours, what sort of videos I would like to make on the twins. And I've just been super, super busy with school and a bunch of other different life stuff. So I figured for the first video that I want to do for the Sedin twins, do something a little bit easier on me and something that I think could still be very, very cool for you guys. I've compiled a few of my favorite moments in Canucks history of the Sedin twins. And I figured that I'll react to them for you guys live, and I think this could be really fun, and let me know if you want to even see more of this in the future. So let's get right into it. So this first clip is what is famously now known in Canucks fandom as the shift. Probably one of the very first shifts where the Sedin twins truly, truly dominated on the ice. This is from the 2007-2008 season. Oh man, the memories right now. Ryan Kessler, of course. Matthias Olin, Henrik Sedin, to Daniel, back to Henrik. Oh, the movement. And Matthias Olin literally was one of the best ever Canuck to patrol the blue line. And by patrol the blue line, I mean he was able to keep the puck in the offensive zone at will, pretty much. Henrik Sedin. In for Daniel. Krejcik's come to the net. Lucas Krejcik, what a name. Oh man. Getting tired now. They've been hemmed in for a while. Henrik Sedin. Daniel. Henrik. There's that attempt for the slap pass or the tip in front. There it is, Olin keeping the puck in. But still the Canucks have the Oilers hemmed in. Krejcik shot. Rollison in the save and he couldn't freeze it. Oilers need a whistle. Krejcik. Oilers do need a whistle, Jim Houston. Off the post. Henrik Sedin, Lucas Krejcik, Henrik. Oh, they used to do that play all the time. I mean, they still do, but they were so good at Henrik on the half wall, passing it into Daniel in the slot for that little one-timer shovel shot. Sheldon Schlurry right there, just diving, just wants to give up. Oh, man. The pressure. Once again, Matthias Olin keeps the puck in. Henrik Sedin, Daniel Sedin, can't get a good shot away. Kessler can't get it. Great puck retrieval by Kessler, too. Man, this power play was so good. Man, I have chills right now. Just everything about this. Sedinery, Kessler, Matthias Olin, Jim Houston making the call. Yeah, they must be, they're gassed. Feel bad for Sheldon Surrey. And the snipe. Alright, so this next clip is from the 2007 playoff series, first round series against Dallas, quadruple overtime. Man, I remember this game too. I remember staying up for this game, it was a school night, and then the next day, all we were talking about was how we were able to stay up late watching this game. I think this was maybe the first year that I truly fell in love with Sedins, because up until then, Marcus Naslin was my favorite player. And this is sort of the time when the Sedins were starting to overtake Naslin and becoming the true next leaders of the franchise. And I mean, as a 10-year-old, I don't really like change, so I was a little almost jealous for Naslin that these young Swedish twins were taking the limelight, but I think this playoff series really cemented my love for the Sedin Twins.
Ever since the overtime started, the Sedin line has been much more dangerous than they were after the first 10 minutes of the first period. And here's a
quadruple overtime. Like, I think Luongo had like 80 something saves. Like, they played two games and a bit. And it's great. It's the twin telepathy. So this next clip might be my most favorite. Just an unreal finish by Daniel. Oh man. And this was to get... This was the like I think this was the last game of the season. Henrik Sedin was in the Art Ross Trophy race and he needed... I can't remember if he was behind or if he was trying to maintain his lead, and I think he ended up getting like 4 points this game to solidify the Art Ross. Oh, so good. No look tip through the legs. Take that, Mika Kiprusoff. Oh, I used to hate Mika Kiprusoff too. Ridiculous goal. I literally have goosebumps. Oh man.
He's got four. 20 seconds apart. Daniel Sedin has his fourth career hat trick.
Absolutely unreal.
High in points. And Henrik Sedin has a 4 point night.
4 points.
He's got a stick on the ice. He directs it. He felt where the pressure was, but he knew exactly.
Effortless. Man. That twin telepathy. Christian Ehrhoff. I purposely didn't put in any Boston Bruins 2011 stuff because I think that would be too hard for me. Okay, next clip. Okay, third round, game two, 2011 playoffs against San Jose. The cycle begins, and like at this point, you really cannot... You can't stop them. Once they get going, you just can't... They draw you in, and then they just pass off. Look at that! He deked through the legs to pass to Henrik. And they are so unbelievably good down low. Oh. Like, they make Aaron Rome look like a god. Sure, some people may not call it exciting hockey, but I honestly, to me, this is the hockey that I love. Great possession. Puck on a string. Ridiculous. So this next one is from 2009, and it kind of proves that the Sedins were more than just cycle players. Spins, pulls it in. Yeah, Quick's gonna want that one back, but like, that's just ridiculous. That guy's happy. Man, and Rogers Arena used to be loud and packed. Ugh. Catches it, too. Man, like, the Sedins are not only great hockey players, but they're great athletes. So this last clip, of course, Henrik's 1,000th goal, or not 1,000th goal, 1,000th point. And this one was super special just because... 1,000 points, all with the same team. Literally, Henrik and Daniel Sedin, the best players to ever put on the Canucks jersey. And I'm so glad both of them got to 1,000 points. Only fitting that it was against Roberto Luongo. I believe the assists were from Alex Edler and Daniel Sedin. Yeah, that's great. I love that. Then this might have been the most emotional I've gotten over a Canucks game in a while, just because, you know, the Canucks have been struggling for so long, but being able to see the two greatest franchise players of all time be able to have this moment, especially Henrik Sedin. Goosebumps, like, man. We'll never see anything like this again. So yeah, oh, it's going to be a very, very weird time as a Canucks fan now without seeing those two those two ginger-haired twins on the ice every night leading the way. I tweeted this out, but it's definitely going to be uncharted waters for fans the same age as myself, or fans who started watching the team at the same time that I did, because the Sedins have been the one true constant on the Canucks. And the way that they've conducted themselves on the ice, through everything, through all the adversity they had to go through at the beginning of their careers, through being called too soft, not good enough at the playoffs. Say what you want about the Boston series, everything they went through with that and the refereeing. They still handled it with class and as true professionals, and I honestly could not be prouder to say that. And literally anyone else was the captain of my favorite team and the assistant captain and the leaders of my favorite team than the Sedin twins. They truly personified what it meant to be a Canuck, and I'm just very, very proud that I was able to, that I could call them Canucks. So I had a lot of fun. I don't know, I definitely had fun watching these clips, but it's the first time I've really gone through some of these old clips in a while, and bringing back some of the memories. I mean, like, this YouTube channel would not be here right now if literally it weren't for the Sedin twins. One of my earliest Canuck fan memories was going to my first Canucks game with my mom, and I was maybe like 7 at the time. Man, I think it was 2003. So what is that? Six or five? I was just starting to get into the Canucks. I had those Save on Foods hockey cards, if you remember what those were, those Save on Foods, the blue hockey cards. So that's how I learned some of the player names, but I still didn't really know much of the players, and the seats were pretty good. They were like lower bowl, maybe 6 or 7 up. And I remember me and my mom were just like very, very confused at why there were one Sedin, we basically thought there was only one Sedin, but each time were wearing different numbers or something stupid like that. Like, it just didn't click to us that they were related or they were brothers, and let alone twins. And I think the people around us were just going, oh man, what a waste of perfectly good seats if you guys don't know who the Sedin twins are. But they definitely sparked my passion for hockey, and yeah, like I said, it's going to be very, very weird not seeing number 22 and number 33 on the ice next season. But I guess truly all I can say is thank you for everything that they've done for the city, for the team, for the fans. They are truly leaving the team in a better place than when they first joined. And I think that speaks volumes to who they were as people, not only players. I really, really want to make a couple more videos on the Sedin twins in these coming days. Like I said, school is very, very hectic, and I'm sorting out some other, life stuff. So I don't think I'm going to be getting a lot of sleep over this week, but I'm definitely going to try and get out a couple more Sedin videos, just because they've been such a huge part in my life, and it's honestly it's kind of still surreal that this is actually happening. Like, I thought I was ready for this, but I wasn't. So yeah, let me know if you want to see more of these reaction videos, because I actually think this could be a really fun idea for a series, going back and maybe looking at some of the best moments from the Chicago series in 2011, or maybe even the Chicago rivalry. There's also one of my favorite playoff series that the Canucks were in, which was one of the first playoff series I remember, was the 2003-2004 season when they lost to Calgary in the first round. I'd also love to go back to maybe generations that I wasn't around for and watching the 94 New York Rangers series or other things like that, and maybe not even strictly Canuck-related. Maybe we react to some prospect stuff, to some other hockey team stuff, compilations. Send me videos that you guys want me to react to, because I think this could be something that's really fun for not only me, but for you guys to watch as well. So definitely let me know. And yeah, with that, I will see you guys tomorrow for Canucks Last Week. This is a great advertisement. I love this. This guy loves it too. Oh yeah, he's loving it.